In the last video, we learned multiple regression. We fitted a linear equation to data. This linear equation has k predictors or independent variables from x1 to xk. We are trying to explain the behavior of y in terms of these k predictors. After the regression, the first question is, how good is the model fit? Just like the simple linear regression with one predictor, we will use R squared for multiple regression, but in a different form. In this video, we will discuss that. Also, you should perform t-test to check the significance of each of the independent variables. The principle and procedure remain the same, so I'll skip that. But in the next video, I'll discuss F-test that you should use to check the overall statistical significance of all the predictors used in your model. First, let me discuss an important relation that is very useful. You have seen this relation earlier. For simple linear regression, I have said that the summation of yi minus y bar square is equal to the summation of yi minus yi hat square plus summation of yi hat minus y bar square. The left hand side term is the TSS, total sum of squares. The first term on the right hand side is called the RSS, residual sum of squares. Sometimes it is also called sum of squared estimate of errors, SSE. The last term is ESS, explained sum of squares. This is also known as sum of squares due to regression, SSR. Do not get confused, just use any of these names. Thankfully, this relationship TSS equal to RSS plus ESS is true even for multiple linear regression. We will use this both in estimating R squared and in F test. But before that, we have to sort out another issue. Degrees of freedom of these three sum of squares, TSS, RSS and ESS. First, the degrees of freedom of RSS. RSS measures the error in the fit of the model. Earlier, I have dealt with that for simple linear regression. There, I argued that with two data points, regression is meaningless. We can fit a straight line exactly to two data points. So the number of data points n must be greater than 2. In other words, the degrees of freedom of RSS is n minus 2. I can write this as n minus k minus 1, where k is the number of predictors. For simple linear regression, we have only one predictor x, so k is equal to 1. Now consider a multiple linear regression with two predictors, x1 and x2. Here we are fitting a plane, and we know that we need three non-collinear points to define a plane. So for regression, we need at least four data points. Otherwise, there will be an exact fit and there will be no need of regression. So the degrees of freedom of RSS should be n minus 3. And that matches with our formulation n minus k minus 1. For this regression, k is 2. We have two independent variables, x1 and x2. So in general, the degree of freedom of RSS is n minus k minus 1. K is the number of independent variables or predictors. Now the degrees of freedom of TSS. In TSS, we are taking the square of the deviation of each y from the mean y. Suppose I have n number of y and I have fixed the mean to y bar. Then I can vary n minus 1 values of y while keeping the mean same. Let me explain. Suppose we have three y's, y1 equal to 2, y2 equal to 1 and y3 equal to 6. So the mean y is 3. Now I want to change the values of y1, y2 and y3 but want to keep the mean at 3. One solution is y1 equal to 3, y2 0, y3 equal to 6. So I kept y3 same, changed y1 and y2 but the mean is still 3. Or another solution could be y1 equal to 2, y2 equal to 3, y3 equal to 4. Now I kept y1 unchanged and changed the other two. And the mean is same, 3. So my degrees of freedom here is 3 minus 1. I cannot change all the y's. I can change only 2. In general, when n is the number of y, degrees of freedom is n minus 1. So the degrees of freedom of TSS is n minus 1, where n is the number of data points. We use a similar logic for ESS. Like TSS, we are taking a deviation from the mean y bar. We are not using the original y values in the data. Here, yi hat is the value obtained from regression model. So we cannot change the value of yi hat as per our whim. In a multiple regression model with k independent variables, we have k plus 1 parameters or coefficient a, b1, b2, b3 and so on to bk. For a given value of predictors, the value of yi hat depends on these k plus 1 parameters. If we want to change yi hat, we have to change this parameter value. Now, how many of those I can change without affecting the mean y? You can use the logic we had for TSS. The answer is k plus 1 minus 1, that is k. So the degrees of freedom of ESS is k, the number of predictors or independent variables in your regression model. Now R square. We use it to check the goodness of fit of our regression model. We use the same approach used for simple linear regression. We ask, how good is our model with respect to the Ohr's model? R squared gives the answer. It is equal to 1 minus RSS by TSS. RSS is the error in our regression model and TSS is the error in the Ohr's model. In the Ohr's model, we consider y is independent of all the predictors. So y is equal to constant. But we have a problem when we use this for multiple regression. Remember that in regression, we are minimizing RSS. So our regression algorithm finds the value of the parameters a, b1, b2 up to bk such that the RSS has the lowest possible value. Now, if we add a new predictor or independent variable in our model, I mean a new x, say xk plus 1, the RSS will either decrease or it will remain same. In general, with the increase in the number of the predictors in our model, RSS drops and the fit of the model to the data gets better. Number of predictors has no effect on TSS. So as RSS drops, the R squared value increases. That indicates that the model is getting better. But that's a trap. We are overfitting. In general, for model fitting, I mean any type of model, as we increase the number of independent variables, the fit improves. But such a well-fitted model has a very little predictive capacity. It will work only when the input values are close to the data that you have used for model fitting. Otherwise also, the general belief in science is that we should always use a simpler model over a complicated one. This idea is known as Occam's razor or parsimony. Suppose we have two models, both explaining a phenomena, but one is simpler with lesser number of independent variables or predictors. Then as per the Occam's razor, choose the simpler model. To bring home the message, let me quote a statement attributed often to von Neumann. With 4 parameters, I can fit an elephant. And with 5, I can make him wiggle his trunk. Good enough. So we should always choose a simpler regression model over a large one. But R squared is misleading us. With every increase in the number of predictors, R squared is increasing as if our model is getting better. So we want to penalize it. But how should I do that? One way to do that is to divide the RSS by its degree of freedom, n minus k minus 1. As the number of predictors increases, both RSS and n minus k minus 1 decreases. So in the ratio form, they adjust each other. Similarly, divide TSS by its degree of freedom, n minus 1. This does not have k, so the number of predictors does not affect. Now we get a modified R square. It is called adjusted R square. I have used a bar above R to differentiate it from the conventional R square. It is equal to 1 minus RSS by TSS into the ratio of n minus 1 div and n minus k minus 1. When k increases, RSS drops. That should increase R squared. But n minus k minus 1 also drops. It is in the denominator. So this whole ratio increases and that reduces R squared. So it gets adjusted. We often rearrange terms and write adjusted R squared as 1 minus R squared into n minus 1 divided by n minus k minus 1. Here the R squared on the right hand side is the conventional R squared. So to evaluate a multiple regression model, use the adjusted R squared, not the conventional R squared. Before I end this video, let's have some fun. Let me restate the statement attributed to Newman. With 4 parameters, I can fit an elephant, and with 5, I can make him wiggle his trunk. In fact, some scholars have fitted a mathematical model to an elephant. I mean, to the cartoon shape of an elephant. This thick black line in the graph is that one. They had 4 complex parameters. With another additional parameter, the 5th one, they could change the position of the trunk. So the trunk is wiggling. Cool, isn't it? I have given the link of the paper here. You may check it. That's all for this video. Happy modeling with multiple regression.